handle people who are upset when their claims are denied? Can you share an experience you had and how you handled it? Now I'll start this one because I've got one that I always, this is my, the one I always go to, because I think it's, when you think about having to deny a claim, it's like everybody's first reaction. My first reaction, and at least it used to be in particular before I kind of had a few things that I figured out, that there's instant anxiety, right? So you're instantly like, this is going to be hard. I'm going to be saying no to this person. You know, they may have tens of thousands of dollars of damage in their basement, but they don't have the endorsement that covers it. And usually it's water claims, right? That this is a thing on, and it's usually on cash. Right? But I mean, daily is the same way. I mean, most of the claims that you're going to handle, that people will handle is on daily, are going to be water claims. So I had a claim once, and it was kind of like a perfect storm of things that we just all went wrong at the same time. So I have a paper system that I've been using since, you know, forever. And I would write the
before
day.
Before computers, we know. Amen.
Right? But I would use a
he called me
clay
Grandpa
tablet
the other day.
And a read, and I would make my – so I would write the date and time and the day of the appointment in the upper right-hand corner of my loss report. I print out all the loss reports, take notes on them, whatever, as I'm on the phone with the person, write their appointment on there, check it off when it's confirmed, and then that's the thing that I stick on my clipboard along with my graph paper when I go to the house. So it's been foolproof. But I wrote down, like, I put my 4 and my 9. I was writing really fast, and I got them mixed up. And so I show up at this guy's house at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And I knock on the door, and I'm, like, you know, smiling or whatever. And I got my clipboard, and I'm all got my shirt on and everything, and my camera, and I'm ready to adjust his claim. And he's like, yes. And I'm like, hey, it's Matt, you know, with your insurance company. I'm just here. And his face started turning bright red. He was like, where have you been, man? You were supposed to be here at 9. So my 9, so I got the I was like, and I looked at my sheet, and I was like, my face turned white, and his face is turning purple. And I was like, listen, I am so sorry. I made it, this is no excuse for this, blah, 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 blah. Yeah, I'm trying to like back out of it. And he's like, my kid's here. He's having his birthday party. His kids are like, you know, 5. There's a bunch of kids running around or whatever. And there's like the neighbors and the kids' parents and stuff. And they're all on the back deck. I can see through the house. And I was like, listen, we'll reschedule at your convenience whenever you want to do this. You know, if tomorrow morning, 8 a.m., I'll be here on the dots for sure. And he's like, no, man, you're here. Let's just do this. And I was like, well,
all
okay,
right,
then.
Let's go.
Right? So in we go. And he's got the sewer and drain backup endorsement. This is a water claim, right?
Okay.
We go down to his basement. And number one, he doesn't have a sump pump. And number two, the floor drain in the basement is in this end of the house, and it's a completely finished basement. The other end of the basement, I was like, so, all right, so I'm like looking for the utility room as we're coming down the stairs, and I'm like peeking around the corner. I see the utility room, and I start to head towards it. I'm like, all right, so show me where the water came in. Because you got to know on a plane like that, you have to know where the source is, whether it's covered or not.
Right.
And he's like, follow me. And he's going the opposite direction. And I was like, okay. And so we get to the other end of the house. It's in this living room. He's got all this nice leather furniture and everything. And there's fans all over the place, and it stinks. He's like, well, it came in underneath that wall over there, I think. I'm pretty sure.
Good. Yeah.
And I was I was like, well, where's your sump pump at? Right. So so basically, to kind of like wrap this up a little bit, he ended up, by the end of this whole thing, he had me like insisted that I was out on the back porch, like shaking hands with all his kid parents and everything. He's trying to get me to eat a sandwich, a burger off the grill, and he's trying to hand me a beer and all that stuff. And the reason why, I had to tell him, I said, listen, you know, we explored every possible thing that we could. We went upstairs. We looked for water coming in upstairs. We looked for, no sump pump. I was like, you sure? Like peeking in behind things. I'm like, there's one you don't know about. It was bone dry in the utility room where the floor drain was. And so that's where the water had to come from in order for it to be covered, right? If it comes under the wall, it's seepage. And then that state, that was it, right? If it came under the wall, no coverage. Right. I explained that to him after I spent a lot of time doing my really kind of going kind of overboard a little bit. But I don't think it was under the circumstances, and really under most circumstances, it probably wasn't. trying to find a way to extend coverage. And he sensed that. He's like, listen, I was like, you know, was there water like in the room there? Could it have like, you know, maybe you saw it flowing this way, but maybe it was also coming the other way. He's like, no. He's like, listen. He's like, finally.
Come on, man. I'm trying to help.
Well, and I wasn't trying to lead him or anything. I was just like, he's like, I understand what you're trying to say. And I'm getting the feeling that this probably isn't covered. And I really, really appreciate you, you know, trying to find a way to help us figure out if we can get this paid for. He's like, it's cool. Come on upstairs. Let's get a beer. Da, da, da. I did not take a beer or a sandwich, by the way. So, but that guy. He sends a letter, right? And he sent a letter to the agent, and that was like a catastrophe denial. Like, I mean, I was like shaking in my boots because I was like, oh man, I mean, this guy, and he was like, he looked broad shoulders and like, you know, Popeye forearms and stuff. And I was like, I mean, I've had people threaten to swing at me before, and I was like, well, this is going to be one of those, but it wasn't. And so denying claims, what I learned from that was that, even if you're paying for part of the claim or you can't pay for all of the claim because some things are limited, right, under certain policies or certain endorsements, you just have to try your best and demonstrate to the homeowner that you are there to help them see if you can cover this. Because so many people, the conventional wisdom is that insurance companies are out to save as much money as possible on your claim as they can and to drag out the process. Those are the two things that you always hear, right? If you can make it look like an efficient, fast process and you give an answer right there on the spot, you know, whether it's covered or not covered and how much you're going to get. And you really sincerely like keep an open mind. Cause sometimes you'll be on the phone with people when you're making your initial contact call and you're like, oh, you're thinking this isn't going to be covered, you know, but it could be, right. Cause sometimes people will open up the door to the basement and they look downstairs, turn the light on, look downstairs and see water. And think, oh, it's probably coming in that wall again when it could have been gushing up out of the floor drain, and they didn't see it, right? So if it's, you know what I mean? So you have to give people the benefit of the doubt, and that's our job is to do that. So if you think about it in terms like that.
Fine coverage.
Yeah. You're there to try to find a way to pay it. And I will tell you right now, in every single orientation meeting I've ever been in my entire life, which has been a lot, the carrier storm managers always said, listen, we really appreciate you guys being here. Get out there and try to find a way to cover this stuff, right? If you have questions, call in, let us know. But don't be out there like, you know, putting big red D's on everything because that's not what we want to do.